A couple of weeks back, I showed you how to truly tweak the graphics of Far Cry 5 to their lowest. But how about the true classic of the franchise? Can we use some of the same knowledge to get Far Cry 4 working? Yes! In fact, you can get this game running on a portable IntelHD power handheld computer, even if it looks a bit bizarre. Do you want to know more? Welcome to the LowSpecGamer, a show where I explore ways of tweaking games to reduce graphics under their normal limits to get them working on low NPCs. So, time to forget about details like accurate skies or bullet holes, because we're going to make this game run. We'll be adding a bunch of commands to the game's configuration files, which is located in your documents folder in the part shown on screen. The full file location and files are in the description if you want to follow along, but let me walk you through some of the most flashy ones, starting with water. This is how water usually looks on the lowest settings. There is still some reflection and refraction, but changes to the water section get rid of some of those subtle details. That is a start. What is... Oh, motherfuck! If you want to get rid of water completely for the best performance result, you can enable disable water and it is gone. The water is still there actually, it's just completely invisible. And it is not rendered at all. Cool. Huh? Oh, seriously? Decals like bullet holes are usually plentiful in this game, but with max decal count, you can control the number of them that are generated. One is the minimum amount, and it only allows for one decal at any given moment. Sadly, zero just crashes the game. In the environment section, you can sort of disable the sky. Usually, clouds and other effects are rendered, but disabling the sky causes a ghosting effect that reminds me a bit of disabling the sky in Half-Life 2. And, excuse me for a moment. And you can reduce texture filtering to dramatically reduce the quality of textures. This one is subtle, but you can definitely notice it in the distance. And just like in Far Cry 5, the low shadows are quite detailed. And even though you cannot disable them, you can use the shadow resolution command to make them significantly lower. Finally, Kill LOD Scale controls the draw distance of a lot of secondary game elements, and putting it to 10 makes them disappear very close to you. You can combine that with LOD Scale, which when set to 10, loads the lowest quality models unless you're right next to them. To test the results of all these changes, I will be using this laptop and... Nope, I am joking, don't click away, get your hand off the mouse. I don't think I have ever seen as many angry comments about using a specific laptop as the ones I have seen in my last three videos. Well, Far Cry 5 is intense enough that, even with the tweaks, that laptop is the lowest I could get away with. Far Cry 4 is a different deal. I like the idea of this game being portable, so I'm going to try it on the M3 and IntelHD powered GPD WIN 2. Since the game has no internal resolution scaler, I will be adding a resolution of 960 by 540 to the GPU panel, and it will show in the menu to be used. The result is... well, even in towns when there are a lot of elements to load, the FPS is maintained over 20, which is not bad. Drive-in does occasionally drop over that, but in my experience, that is as bad as it gets. Once you are on and about, hunting or fighting, the thieves might actually allow you to play this game. Now, if you have noticed a steady increase in the quality of this video over the last few months, that is because Joe, the LowSpec editor, has been hard at work at learning new tricks for video creation. If you want to be a creator of any kind or improve any skill, the internet is your best friend, and Skillshare is the best option out there. They have courses on everything from video editing to nature photography, although I might want to skip that last one because nature is where the eagles are at. The first 200 people to use this link will get 2 months of premium access for free. Thank you to them for sponsoring this video, and thank you if you are part of the elite group supporting this content in Patreon. Okay.